As we celebrate the 21st Sunday in Ordinary Time, let's all stand and join in singing our gathering song. Number 592, We Are the Light of the World. Number 592.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the high.
us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Joshua. Joshua gathered together all the tribes of Israel at Shechem, summoning their elders, their leaders, their judges, and their officers. When they stood in ranks before God, Joshua addressed all the people. If it does not please you to serve the Lord, decide today whom you will serve. The gods your fathers served beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose country you are now dwelling. As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. But the people answered, far be it from us to forsake the Lord for the service of other gods, for it was the Lord our God who brought us and our fathers up out of the land of Egypt, out of a state of slavery. He performed those great miracles before our very eyes and protected us along our entire journey and among the peoples through whom we passed. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God. The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians, brothers and sisters. Be subordinate to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives should be subordinate to their husbands as to the Lord. where the husband is head of his wife, just as Christ is head of the church, he himself the Savior of the body. As the church is subordinate to Christ, the wives should be subordinate to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and handed himself over for her to sanctify her, cleansing her by the bath of water with the word, that he might present to himself the church in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. So also husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one hates his own flesh, but rather nourishes and cherishes it, even as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak in reference to Christ and the church, the word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Many of Jesus' disciples who were listening said, "This saying is hard. Who can accept it?" Since Jesus knew that his disciples were murmuring about this, he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the spirit that gives life, while the flesh is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are spirit and life, but there are some of you who do not believe." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the ones who would betray him. And he said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former ways of life, and no longer accompanied him. Jesus then said to the 12, "Do you also want to leave?" Simon Peter answered him, "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord. Today's Gospel presents us with a powerful and thought-provoking question from Jesus. What about you? Do you also wish to go away? This question posed to the 12 disciples echoes through the centuries and reaches to us today. Do you also wish to go away? It is a question that demands a response, a question that invites us to examine our own hearts and our commitment to following Christ. In the Gospel, many of Jesus' disciples found his teachings too demanding and his words too difficult to accept. They could not comprehend the mystery of the Eucharist, the idea that Jesus is the bread of life come down from heaven. And his language seemed intolerable, his claims too radical. And so they turned away and stopped following him, just as it is happening in our times. There are people who are leaving the churches, who are leaving Jesus, who are abandoning their faith. And Jesus did not run after them. He did not try to water down his message to make it more palatable. And he spoke the truth and let them make their choices. And then Jesus turned to the 12 and asked, "Do you also wish to go away?" Imagine the scene, 12 disciples standing right in front of Jesus. And Jesus standing there, looking into the eyes of his closest followers and disciples and friends. Those who walked with him, seen his miracles, heard his teachings. They too must have been confused, uncertain, perhaps even tempted to leave. They did not know where Jesus was leading them. The road ahead was unclear, filled with uncertainties and challenges. Yet they stayed, like most of us. Peter, speaking on behalf of the 12, responds with words that have echoed through the ages and centuries. "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life, and we have believed and have come to know that you are the Holy One of God." Peter's response is not born out of complete understanding or perfect knowledge or intelligence. It is a response of faith, of trust, of a deep conviction that even in the midst of uncertainties, Jesus is the one to whom they must cling. And fidelity to Jesus is often tested in times of incomprehension, in moments when we do not understand. Fidelity is tested when the path is unclear, when life presents us with challenges and difficulties. When the teachings of Christ seem hard to accept, and yet it is precisely in these moments that our faith is deepened, our trust is strengthened. You know, human nature, we often want to understand first before we believe. We want clear answers, logical explanations, tangible proofs. But Jesus invites us to a different path, to a path where we are called to believe first in order to understand. Could be a blind belief, but Jesus invites us for that blind belief in him. because he knows where he is leading us. Faith precedes understanding. Trust comes before knowledge. It is only through a relationship with Christ, through walking with him, staying with him, even when the road is difficult, that we come to understand who he is and what he is calling us to. Today, Jesus asks us the same question. Do you also wish to go away? No, we don't want to go. This is the reason we are here. We believe in him. We love him. We know the importance of being a Christian, being a Catholic, being a follower of Jesus. And like Peter, we are invited to respond with faith. Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. And let us stay with Jesus, even when we do not fully understand, even when his teachings challenge us, even when the road is hard. Let us trust that he is leading us, that he is with us, and that he alone has the words of eternal life. Dear Lord, I do not want to leave you. Let my heart believe that my mind cannot understand. Lord, I love you, even though I do not fully understand you. Let me seek you with my heart, that my love may find you. Jesus, I trust in you.
Of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God's love and mercy, we now offer him our prayers.
That we as members of the church may share the saving message of Jesus through our compassionate outreach to others and by lives of faithful witness. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of our military, police, and firefighters, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Archbishop Dennis Schnur, may he be strengthened and restored to full health. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Westside Catholic family of parishes, may the Holy Spirit increase his gifts in us to move boldly into our new family. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may abound in generosity, mercy, and protection for all people of the world. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that those who have died in God's grace may taste and see the goodness of the Lord in eternal life. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Kevin Cook, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, graciously hear these prayers and the prayers that are in our hearts. Grant us through Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Number 655, increase our faith. Number 655.
And sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Amen.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, our spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis of Pope, Dennis of Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Number 936, gather in your name. Number 936.
Blessed and poured out for all.
this place. Bread, the gift of your body. Wine, the lifeblood outpoured. Come to the feast, take and believe, become what you receive. When two or more gather in your name and see your presence in each face, we treasure the gift of this sacred meal, blessed and poured out for all in this place. Bread, our light and our life. Wine, our truth and our way. Come join the feast, take and believe, become what you receive. When two sacred meal, blessed and poured out for all in this place. Number 781, Lord, when you came to the seashore. Number 781. smiling, my name you were saying. All I treasured, I have left on the sand there. Close to you, I will find a sea.
Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us so that in all things we may please you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
Number 615, Holy God, we praise thy name. Number 615.